Okay. Lots of trees. I'm from Fredericton, but they're cutting a lot of trees lately. But we're going to talk about trees. How you doing?
Good.
And your name is?
I'm Tracy Glenn.
You're working for who?
I'm the Acadian Forest Campaigner at the Conservation Council.
What's that, Acadian Forest?
The Acadian Forest is the native forest type in New Brunswick, so it's a... The name was given by a researcher from Environment Canada in the 1970s. So it's the forest type that we have in the province with the mixture of softwood trees, the boreal, the pines and the spruce and the fir, and then the hardwoods, the leafy trees, so the maples, the birches, the beeches.
And where is it?
So it covers, it's the forest found, it's a native forest in New Brunswick, but it's also found in the Maritime provinces and parts of southern Quebec and into the United States.
Oh, really? That large?
Yeah, so it's that mixture, that mixed wood forest that's found in our area.
Okay.
But unfortunately, we're clear cutting and replacing our native forests with plantations, so it's turning into a boreal forest that you see in other when you go across Canada, the boreal forest, just that evergreen forest. So we are, wiping out the diverse forests that we have.
That's what it's really, learn something new every day. Where would the Acadian Forest be here in New Brunswick?
Well, it's the native forest of the entire province. Of course,
percentage is there from Acadian Forest here in this province?
Well, it's what the native forest is in the province. So it's if we restored the land or left it alone after a clear cut, it would regenerate. But when we are currently replacing that native forest with these plantations, and in the recent forest policy decision, they've allowed an increase in that plantation area. So when you're driving along the highway, often we don't see the forest anymore. What we see is rows of trees, rows of either.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Yeah.
I don't, it's not nice.
No, it's not.
No. How much percentage of Acadian forest is there left, do you know, here in this province? I mean, the original?
Well, if we look at, so what we've done recently with our mapping project is...
What's the website?
Acadianforest.ca.
Okay.
So we looked at, these maps show you what's left of intact forests. So that's, when we say intact, we mean areas of 30,000 hectares right now and of an age of 35 years old or more.
Mm-hmm.
So outside of the 3% protected forests, which is very small, but we are increasing that by a little bit to 8%, this map shows you that we don't have large intact swaths of old forests left in this province.
So why are we, of all the 10 provinces in Canada, are we the worst to clear cut and don't replant, or are we replanting the wrong way in the wrong,
we are behind other provinces, or I think in terms of forest management, in terms of like what people want to see today. So people don't want to see clear cutting, and they don't want to have their forests sprayed with herbicides from helicopters and planes. So when we look at Quebec banned herbicide spraying of their crown land, public land. We should also recognize that the land in New Brunswick's never been ceded, so that's another issue with the fact that First Nations in this province are not being consulted on land that they never gave up.
What does that mean, ceded?
So ceded means that there's peace and friendship treaties, so there's obligations from both of us over this land in this province, but the land has never been signed away in an agreement. So the crown, the province is supposed to be, as the trustee of the public lands here, managing for the benefit of all New Brunswickers while also recognizing Aboriginal treaty rights, which they don't do because... we see that First Nations are not consulted in forest policies. But going back to the herbicide spraying, so Quebec banned herbicide spraying of their public lands over a decade ago, Nova Scotia stopped the public funding of herbicide spraying on their public land. So we are continuing to, all New Brunswickers are paying because they see this as an investment. So we all pay for the spraying of the...
Do we still spray?
Yes, we do. We're actually spraying right now. So it started on August 8th.
What are we spraying?
We spray glyphosate-based herbicides. So they are...
The beetle, or I guess the beetle?
No, it's for the plantation. So it's to get rid of the hardwoods that are competing with the softwoods.
Because
they want a softwood plantation, right, to feed their mills. And the companies, J.D. Irving and A.B. Nockwick, et cetera, want a certain type of tree, the softwood trees. So they, when an area's been clear cut, the different trees come up, and they want to get rid of the hardwoods so that they don't compete with the softwoods. So it's a herbicide that's applied. But so those glyphosates that we spray on the forest are currently under review by Health Canada because of recent scientific studies that show human health impacts and impacts on wildlife. So Quebec banned herbicide spraying because...
Hold that. End up part one. Hold it. Yeah. This is good. This is really...